This is Filippo Scaglia. I am the legal advisor in Hanoi for the Andrea Partner Legal Counsel. And today I'm gonna share with you a brief presentation, just a few slides, that might be helpful to understand how to do business in Vietnam. But first, I would like also to give you a quick introduction of our firm, about who we are and what we do. So I will just start and share the slides with you. This is our firm, and this is our key practice area. As you can see, we provide legal services for international companies that are active around the world, mostly in China, Italy, Vietnam, Dubai, Russia, and India. And we provide services related to corporate and commercial law, but also to corporate M&A, IPR protection and labor law, and any related matters to these main areas. We are proud to announce that in Vietnam we have been active for a few years already, and we have successfully published a series of practical guides regarding that regarding doing business in Vietnam that are helpful to foreign investors that are just entering this new market and this new country, and they need some practical information. The first is about foreign direct investment. The second is the industrial zone, and the third one is about the certificate of origin. So, in particular, how to get the Made in Vietnam stamp or certification for your products. So let's get to today's content of our presentation. I will just give a brief introduction of the country, then how to do business in Vietnam, and at last we will get into the incorporation procedure for companies here in Vietnam. So why Vietnam? What is it about Vietnam? What makes it What keep it under the radar for in the last years? Why everyone is talking about Vietnam? Because, as you can see, Vietnam is one of the most rapidly emerging countries, I would say, in the world, for sure in Southeast Asia. And it has been constantly growing at interest rates of the GDP by 6.5% per annum. And there are many factors that make Vietnam market appealing for foreign investors. But if I have to mention one that is probably the most relevant, is that Vietnam has so far entered about 16 free trade agreements. And the most recent one, the last two, were entering into force in 2020. The first one is the European-Vietnam Free Trade Agreements, which grants duty exemption and other preferential treatments to companies that do trades among European countries and Vietnam. And the second one, most for importance, is the RCEP, which members are basically all the Asian countries, including China and Australia and New Zealand. And again, it grants tax exemption, duty exemption for goods exchanged among all these countries. So, how to do business in Vietnam? How to enter the market? How to enter this country? In our experience, we believe that the options are basically the most common and used option are two. The first one is to set up a representative office. The second one is to set up a limited liability company. So, what is a representative office? A rep office. Basically, it is useful for companies that are still in an early stage of the investment, that still need to study the market and to understand which one is the better approach, the better strategy to enter the market. But by establishing a representative office, you will have a physical presence in the territory, and you will be allowed to attend events, to have business meeting, to visit any potential client or potential partner in the country. You will start to explore the business environment in Vietnam. What you cannot do as you set up a representative office is performing any business related activities, meaning you cannot issue invoices, so you cannot have clients, you cannot have profits. But what you can do is perform any business development activities. So it has his function, it has some limitation, some restriction, but for a company that is making the first steps into this business environment, it is a useful option. The second option is setting up a limited liability company. It can be 100% owned by foreign individuals or foreign organization, or you can set up a joint venture with a local partner, with a foreign partner. It depends on which kind of industries or sector or business lines you are investing. There are a few of the conditional business lines which prescribed by law to have a local partner, but still it is a very narrow list of industries because I can honestly say that the major business sector you are free to open your country and have it 100% on your ownership, under your ownership. While the third aspect that we always mention to our clients is taking care of intellectual property rights, because it is of paramount importance to protect your IPR even before entering the country, even before starting the application procedure to set up, to establish a company or any other legal entity in Vietnam. Because Vietnam, as many other countries, apply the first to file rule. So it means that you have to be first. If you come in second, it's not that relevant. You will be able to protect your trademark or your logo or your patent or your copyright, but it will be more time consuming and the result is not granted. You might not be able to protect your trademark, your interest, and to use your logo. So the application for trademarks, the procedure is quite straightforward. It's nothing complicated. You just have to fill out the form and include all the basic information and relevant information. However, the procedure to get the result from the NYP, it takes quite a long time. It takes about 18 months, maybe more, so about 1.5 years, almost 2 years to get the result. It is retroactive. I mean, once you get the result, your property rights, your intellectual property rights are covered and protected since the first day, since the day that you filed the application. So there is no problem of coverage and protection, but still you have to wait for the result to actually know if you are covered. So we always suggest our clients to start thinking about registering your trademarks and your logo and your copyright even before entering the country. Now let's get to the incorporation procedure. There are two main steps, two main phases. The first one is for foreign investor only, and is to submit the application to get the investment registration certificates. This is the most important and the most relevant for foreign investors. It is only required for foreign investors because for Vietnamese and for local companies, the incorporation procedure only provides for the enterprise registration certificate. The IRC application, the dossier that you will have to submit to the authorities, the dossier shall include all the basic information, all the relevant information that usually are included also in your business plan. So you will have to include information regarding the chartered capital, the number of the employees, the location, the address of your office. If you have a production facility, where is it located? If you plan to expand in the next 3 or 5 years. So they have to be not doesn't have to be very specific by numbers and data, but still has to be reasonable. Also in respect of regarding of the charter capital, because this is a question that we get often about how much is the minimum charter capital required by law. There is no minimum required by law. However, we always, in our experience, we believe that for a basic investment, for a, let's say, for a service provider company, a reasonable amount would be around $10,000, because there is no minimum amount required by law, but still you have to show, you have to provide the authorities that your investment is serious, and so that's why they ask for the business plan, because they want to compare if your investment is on the same page of your project. So it has to be reasonable. That's it. That's the basic rule. The second step, once you have to obtain the IRC, would be to get the ERC. The ERC, basically, in the dossier that you have to submit for the application, you have to include all the basic and relevant information for establishing the company. Nothing very complicated. The application is quite straightforward, and we can say that for both steps, it usually require a minimum of 2 months and about 3 or 4 months if there is some minor issue and you have to resubmit, but between 2 or 4 months, usually you can get your company set up fully. The third step is only optional, it's not required for all the industries, for all the companies, but if you invest in conditional business lines, starting by the name, you have to meet some condition and you have to ask to submit a request to obtain a business license to operate legally in this business sector. That would be all, and thank you for attention. I hope that it has been useful and interesting for you, for anyone is thinking to approach the Japanese market. And if you have any other comment or doubt or inquiry, please get in touch with us. You can find our email address down below. Please write us. We will be glad to answer all your questions. Thanks again, and I wish you all a great day.